Brett Kavanaugh's Yale roommate, though, is speaking out, and we need to talk about that. His name is James Roche, and he's telling Anderson Cooper just a little while ago that he believes Deborah Ramirez's accusations that Kavanaugh exposed himself to her. Watch it.
I know this girl, and she didn't lie, and she wouldn't lie, and I can't see any reason why she would. And so it felt to me like somebody had to get up and speak for her. Now, other people have, and I think that's terrific. But as Brett's roommate, I'm in a singular position, at least of the people who are willing to talk, to say, hey, listen, I saw him do this stuff that he said under oath that he didn't do. I saw him use words in a different way than the way he said under oath they were used. You know, if a person isn't truthful about these little things, then we ought to think very seriously about whether we should tell Debbie that she's wrong or crazy and believe him.
As I said, it is a very busy news night here, as you can see, beginning with our breaking news. And we've got more to come, much more to come on all of this. You're going to hear a lot more from that roommate tonight. But there is something that we really have to talk about tonight, okay? And it is this. It's the way that this president, the most powerful man in the world, consistently claims to be a victim. Honestly, this is a man who was born into tremendous wealth. He was a millionaire when he was 8 years old. And I don't mean his father was a millionaire. His father gave him millions, making him a millionaire by the time he was 8 years old. The New York Times reports his father gave him the equivalent of $413 million. He's plastered his name on buildings around the world. He married one beautiful woman after another, and divorced, and had six children among them. Turned his fame into reality TV stardom. And now he lives in the White House. Only Donald Trump could call himself a victim with a straight face. But he does it again and again and again. He did it today, tweeting that the Times had done a so-called hit piece on him, his attorney threatening to sue the paper. He did it last night.
I've had many false accusations. I've had it all. I've had so many. And when I say it didn't happen, nobody believes me. They can say anything they want, and we can't sue them, because if you're famous, you can't sue. Figure that one out.
This president has made himself the victim in chief from the early days of his presidency.
Look at the way I've been treated lately, especially by the media. No politician in history, and I say this with great surety, has been treated worse or more unfairly.
So you know what's unfair? Repeatedly claiming with absolutely no evidence that your predecessor was not even born in this country. That's unfair, but I digress. Let's not forget that President Trump's favorite claim, say it with me, he's a victim of a witch hunt.
It's a total witch hunt. I've been saying it for a long time.
They have this witch hunt.
I have this witch hunt.
It's a witch hunt. That's all it is.
They have phony witch hunts.
It's like a witch hunt. It's like a witch hunt.
The witch hunt continues. The entire thing has been a witch hunt.
This is a pure and simple witch hunt.
Donald Trump has been harping on this claim of being a victim his entire life. His ghostwriter, the guy who really wrote the book, The Art of the Deal, Tony Schwartz, told the Washington Post that Trump's first move in the face of criticism has always been to assume the role of victim. Unfair has long been one of his favorite words. He always perceives himself as the victim, so he feels justified in lashing back at his perceived accusers. Me, 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 me. I'm the victim. I'm the victim. I'm the victim of a New York Times hit piece on my taxes. White men like me and like Brett Kavanaugh are the victims of false accusations.
This is an important time for our country. This is a time when your father, when your husband, when your brother, when your son could do great. Mom, I did great in school. I've worked so hard. Mom, I'm so pleased to tell you, I just got a fantastic job with IBM. Mom, a terrible thing just happened. A person who I've never met said that I did things that were horrible, and they're firing me from my job, Mom. I don't know what to do. Mom, what do I do? What do I do, Mom? What do I do, Mom? It's a damn sad situation, okay?
Boy, that is quite a story. None of it's true. If it could happen to me, it could happen to you. If it could happen to Brett Kavanaugh, it could happen to anybody. And you know who else thinks the whole thing is just so unfair?
Now, I know that in this week in particular, you're not allowed to have a beer if you are a conservative. Now, if you're a liberal, you can do cocaine and you can be the president.
Like father, like son. Victims. 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 Poor little rich boys. You know what else you can apparently do and be the president? You can brag about sexual assault.
I better use some Tic Tacs just in case they start kissing her. You know, I'm automatically attracted to beautiful. I just start kissing them. It's like a magnet. You just kiss. I don't even wait. And when you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything.
Whatever you want.
Grab them by the pussy. I can do anything.
I'm just saying. But he's a victim. You can insult gold star families.
If you look at his wife, she was standing there. She had nothing to say. She probably, maybe she wasn't allowed to have anything to say. You tell me.
This is just the truth. I mean, come on, think about this. You can have a massive $25 million fraud judgment against you, all that, and you can still be president. If you're Donald Trump, that is. Can you imagine? Can you imagine? No, honestly, let's think about this. Can you imagine if Barack Obama had one of these things against him? If he had three wives that he cheated on and six children? Never taking responsibility. Never apologizing. Always siding with the accused and not the accuser. Never the accuser. And it's really no surprise. I mean, after all, this president has stood behind, again, facts, stood behind accused child molester Roy Moore.
He totally denies it. He says it didn't happen. And, you know, you have to listen to him also.
Are you
about, he said 40 years ago this did not happen.
He has stood behind accused domestic abuser Rob Porter.
He also, as you probably know, he says he's innocent. And I think you have to remember that. He said very strongly yesterday that he's innocent.
Mm-hmm. And now he's standing behind Brett Kavanaugh.
He's a very well-known, the most highly respected person until the last couple of weeks, because they're destroying him and they're destroying his reputation. And we can't let that happen. We can't. Can't let it happen.
So come on, let's be honest. This president is no victim. He was elected to the highest office in this country, to the most powerful position, really, in the world. Why is he constantly complaining?